Welcome to In Your Neighborhood. I'm your host, Chris O'Rourke, and behind me is the Wall of Fame here at Vapor Trail 24/7 in Bloomsburg. This is a place where athletes of any age can come to learn one thing, how to run faster. I always thought that you couldn't teach speed. It's something you were born with. Either you had it or you didn't. Take Bloomsburg grad Javel Hemphill, for example. This guy is a speed burner, scorching the track at Shippensburg for four straight AA state championships in the 100-meter dash, as well as establishing a state record. Example number two, Southern Columbia grad and current Ohio State Buckeye Julian Fleming, who finished second in last year's AA dash. Pretty good arguments for my way of thinking. So, imagine how I felt when I was proven wrong. For that example, I turned to Shamokin grad Blake Zalar, an offensive lineman who was told to run the 100 in track, which he did dutifully, buying into the idea, despite some finger pointing and chuckles. There was one person who didn't have that reaction, James Franklin, head football coach at Penn State, who gave Zalar a call based solely on video of him running the 100. And he's now a Nittany Lion. The man who told Zalar to run the 100 is Tom Hughes, the owner of Vapor Trail 24/7. He calls that Franklin phone call to Zalar one of his proudest moments as a speed coach. Hughes first started his operation 5 years ago, letting his kids choose the name. Vapor Trail is one of the names for the exhaust product of a jet, and 24/7 because he literally will head to his Bloomsburg facility whenever you need him to be there. He was working with 73 local athletes pre-COVID in either an individual manner, as a group, or as a team. He will work with athletes of any age, although he's quick to point out that some younger kids aren't mature enough to buy into his program.
Our motto is, you can teach speed. And The thing about it is oftentimes people think you're born running fast. Well, you're not. You're born running mechanically correct. So what happens is somebody might flail their arms and another kid's born running with their arms close to their body and a good arm drive and a good knee drive. So therefore, what they're doing is covering more distance than the person next to them. Speed is distance in Vapor Trail's gym. So if we can teach you distance, we're going to teach you speed.
Hughes was a bit of a speed merchant himself in his younger days, winning triple jump gold at states as a senior at Bloomsburg, and then becoming Susquehanna University's first All-American as a nationals qualifier. Following a six-year stint in Green Bay, he returned to our area and was asked to coach the women's track team at Susquehanna by his former coach and legend, Jim Taylor. Then, Bloomsburg approached him about returning to his alma mater to coach track and field. What followed was a very successful stint with 7 state champions and 97 state medal winners. When it became time for him to move on, it was his wife and brother-in-law who talked him into starting his own business, and a trip to California then helped him to focus on speed.
When I first started, what we did is we've been fortunate to have a relationship with Mamba Sports Academy. That's Kobe Bryant's gym out in Thousand Oaks, California. And through our relationship with them, I had a meeting. And initially, what I was trying to do was, you just want to collect money. You want to just make sure that your income is good enough for you where you can survive. So you're thinking about having Vapor Trail football. You're thinking about having Vapor Trail 7-on-7 baseball. And when I had a meeting with them, they said, listen, we understand what you're trying to do because a lot of people try to do that, but what you want to do is pinpoint and laser focus on what you do. And the funny thing out there was that in California, they even asked me, was I a speed coach or a footwork coach? So they have it so narrowed down that they have it, you know, divided in that area. And when I came back from those meetings, when I really laser focused on just being a speed train, that's all we do is speed train, make kids faster. And it's really been successful for us.
He was already coaching 5 or 6 kids before Vapor Trail 24/7. And his brother-in-law then gave him a 3-page, 4-step business model to follow. One was to find a venue. Check. Then the next was to begin pursuing athletes, which came naturally to him since he was used to recruiting in college and talking high school athletes into coming out for track and field. He touched base with some of the top athletes in this area to see if they wanted to do some things, and then relied on word of mouth, and his reputation with Bloomsburg Track and Field pretty much spoke for itself. Another check. He worked with Hemp Hill with a result that also speaks for itself. He got out of bed at 4 some mornings to coach Bloomsburg standout jumper and state champion Brittany Phillips. Lauren Ball is among his proteges, along with Shikellamy grad and baseball standout Nick Dunn. But Fleming may be his biggest name up to this point. The Tiger first came to Hughes at the end of his freshman year.
When I first started training Julian, I had to stop myself from watching him. From when he first walked in the gym, I would watch him work out like a fan and be like, oh my goodness, I can't believe he can do that. I can't believe he can do that. Then when the dust kind of settles, then you get into it and you find out that, you know, this young man is a teenager. He's trying to be great. There's a lot of things that we try to do, and there's a lot of things that Vapor Trail has incorporated for him. I know one of the things that when he ran track, he was coming out of the starting blocks with his incorrect foot. And then after that was last year, and after that, you know, we went and talked about it and rectified the problem. And then that's when he ran his fastest time. He ran a 10.8 and 100, took second place in the 100-meter dash. But, yeah, there's some things that we do for him, and now that he's home from Ohio State, he's came to to work out with us. So I'm still feeling pretty good that even though he's at Ohio State and getting probably the best training ever, you know, that he still looks to come back to us.
Hughes ended up making quite a connection with Southern's magical teams of the past 3 years, working with Stone Hollenbaugh, Gage Garcia, Cal Halliday, Preston Zachman, and Max Tillett. He has also coached former Selinsgrove Grove quarterback Danny Shock, taking him to California where he was one of 15 kids invited to a quarterback camp. Speed is the focus for these players whose names you may have heard before, and the dozens of others that Hughes works with in various drills at this facility, on tracks, in the soon-to-be 40-yard sand pit that will be located out back of this place. Sand training is big in California and with NFL prospects getting ready for the combine. All of these athletes not only want to excel on the high school level, but have their eyes on the bigger picture, competing on the collegiate level. And once again, it all comes back to speed.
The speed's always a big factor.
It's the factor. You know, it's the factor. So, you know, we had a young man that was, you know, called by a Division I football coach. And when they call you, what they talk about is your speed. I mean, they talk about your 40. They don't ask you other stuff. They want to know how fast you run because they know they can make you what they want you to be. So the prime thing is to get faster. And the thing that we are always butting our head against is that oftentimes people don't think they are faster.
One place where speed isn't necessarily required, at least not for running, is at a local TV operation. But it goes without saying that I'm going to see if Hughes can teach an old dog some new tricks. So he starts me off with three drills. Running high knee.
Same thing.
Running with butt kicks.
Good.
And running like a drum major. After I get through with those, he makes a correction. He wants me to run with my hands spread wide open and straight up and down, with plenty of shoulder movement to get my arms going.
The reason why we have open fingers is because it keeps everything linear, right? So remember I said speed is distance?
Yes.
So if I'm running like this, my steps are coming. So there's no purpose to my steps. They're coming side to side, so I'm not getting as much distance. If I keep them linear, everything is here. Okay? Now, fingers open again. If my knee drive is here, I go this far. If I change my mechanics, it goes this far. There's your speed.
Right.
Okay? So what happens is this. The arms talk to the legs. So whenever a Vapor Trail kid runs, they run with their arms. They don't run with their legs. When I'm getting in the race, I'm talking to my arms. Just like that pitcher. See what I'm saying?
So the focus should be on getting on good arm drive.
That's it, and the legs will follow.
Okay.
Okay, so now what I'm just gonna have you do is a nice easy run to that cone and back.
Okay.
So feel how you have more bounce in your step?
Yeah.
Yes, good. Okay, so now we're gonna try one thing, even though we didn't go that long. You're gonna do one form. When you get ready, we call that loading. So you're gonna get ready to run, okay, like you're gonna go. And when you run this time, so get ready. When you run this time, I want you to run like before you met me.
What does that mean?
Good. Good. You don't know how to run like you used to.
Right.
We've spent what?
Just 5 minutes.
3 minutes?
Yeah,
5 minutes?
Like that, yeah.
So that's, oh my God, you're the best. You made me look so good. But you, that's what happens with kids.
Right.
I'll say, all right, get ready. And they freeze. And I said, well, you don't know how to do it anymore. So imagine coming here for 4 years, 2 years, a year, 6 months, and have to run to 40, and you're mechanically incorrect or mechanically correct.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying?
Yep.
So that's the test.
And it's a test that even a washed-up TV person can pass. So imagine how a young, impressionable teenager handles all of this input. Soaking up each piece of advice, each drill like a sponge as they strive to be the fastest athlete they can be. While Tom let us in on some of his secrets to his success, there are other special secrets he wouldn't divulge that he says they give their athletes to prepare for races. These are things that Hughes hasn't just developed over the 5 years he's been running Vapor Trail 24/7. They go back to the start of his coaching career, about 15 years, and even beyond that, when he was a young athlete soaking in everything his high school and college coaches taught him.
To be honest with you, I never pursued coaching. Coaching pursued me. Coach Taylor asked me to be a coach, and I said yes. I couldn't say no to him. And then I was pursued by Bloomsburg High School to be their coach. And again, you had a lot of people that were asking me for help. And it was something that organically came towards me instead of me towards it. And the reason why I think I do well at it is because I understand the local athlete. I understand what it takes to be successful in this area, the good and the bad of being successful in this area. And I really think I speak their language when I'm here. And there's a lot of empathy behind, you know, a lot of kids. They don't get what maybe kids from an urban area will get as far as exposure or recognition. So it was something that I really wanted to hang my hat on.
Hughes says he has trained hundreds of kids, with as many as 70 coming in a week over the summer. When we come back, we will introduce you to a young lady who accomplished quite a feat.